Good morning, boss.
Good morning, Tattoo. That's a nice-looking horse.
What horse? Oh, you mean, that horse.
Ah, you see him now, do you? Where do you come from?
Well, boss, that's a funny story. I was walking down the south side of the island.
Yes?
And there he was. And he followed me home.
I see. Then you did nothing to encourage him to follow you, huh?
Oh, no, boss. I wouldn't do something like that.
We'll discuss this later, too.
All right, boss.
What horse, indeed?
Mr. Joe Kappas and his wife, Eve, from San Pedro, California. Mr. Kappas is a commercial fisherman aboard a tuna boat.
Mrs. Kappas looks beautiful.
And a devoted wife. Mrs. Kappas looks to her husband's few needs, keeps a modest, very happy home, and accepts life as it comes.
Sounds like they have everything. What are they doing on Fantasy Island?
Well, they have almost everything, Tattoo. But you see, Mr. Kappas has a fantasy. Ever since his childhood, he's wondered what it would be like to be worth millions of dollars.
So do I, boss.
Yes, my dear friend. But there is a difference. Mr. Kappas is about to find out. Miss Claire Conti.
She don't look very happy.
She's a very troubled young lady. The man with her is Mr. Eddie Loomis, her boyfriend. And the other lady is the celebrated medium, Madame Estelle Boyk.
Medium? You mean like a ghost, seances, all that stuff?
Precisely.
What do you want from us?
Nothing more than a chance for Miss Conti to talk to her twin brother.
That's all?
Oh, that's all, Tattoo. But it's not as easy as you might think. You see, Miss Conti's brother has been dead for a year now. My dear guests, I am Mr. Rourke, your host. Welcome to Fantasy Island.
This house. When I was a kid, there was a painting in the front room of my house. It looked exactly like this, you know. I remember it as a kid, but it's impossible.
Is it, Mr. Kappas?
You seem to forget this is Fantasy Island.
Why are we here? I mean, what does it all mean?
It means this is where your fantasy begins. This is where you and Mrs. Kappas will remain until your fantasy to become rich is fulfilled. If you'll excuse us, we have other guests to attend to.
Good luck to both of you.
Batum.
Already.
Miss Lesieva and Mr. Marat arrive on an earlier plane. Please, make yourselves comfortable.
Eddie Loomis, Madame Vork. This is my Uncle Victor, my cousin Claude Marat, and his wife Denise.
Pleasure.
Oh, we mustn't be too hasty. And Mr. Loomis, may I remind you, this is a family matter.
But Eddie is my fiancé. And besides, he was a friend of Tom's.
A friend of Tom's?
Well, that's fitting. After all, we are here for a seance for poor, dear, dead Tom.
If you're not a believer, you have no place here.
On the contrary, Madame Vorek, in spite of your influence over my niece, I am the executor of her trust. As such, I may not be able to stop her making a fool of herself, but I can prevent her from being swindled.
Uncle Victor, please.
Are you calling me a swindler?
Well, you must admit that you are the prime suspect, what with your seances and your floating trumpets and spook shows and whatever. Not to mention you're convincing my niece that her twin brother is trying to contact her from the world beyond.
But Tom is. At least I think he is.
But you've had other seances with Madame Vork, and nothing happened.
Denise has a point. What makes you think that Tom will contact us here? On Fantasy Island. Or perhaps we should ask that of our host, Mr. Rourke.
Perhaps you should, Mr. Lefevre. Your niece's fantasy was to find a place where the psychic emanations of her late twin brother would be comfortable.
And you found such a place?
Oh, we found such a place, Mr. Lefevre. And I'm afraid before I allow any of you to go there, I must warn you that you could be probing into areas where perhaps mortals were not meant to probe.
You do that very well, ominous warning. I think we'll risk it.
In that case, I'll arrange this afternoon to have you taken to the other side of the island, where this house is located.
Oh, my God. That's the house where Tom and I grew up. It burned to the ground when we were 9 years old.
Indeed. Until this afternoon, then.
You must be tired. You've been walking for hours.
It's like being a kid again. Waiting for my father and grandfather to come back from the boat. Talking and dreaming about lost treasures. Except there aren't any lost treasures for people like us. You know, the sea took everything my father and grandfather had and gave back nothing.
Well, they earned a living, Joe. And they also raised beautiful families.
Yeah, I know, but just once, I really want to be rich, you know, real rich and big cars and 2 swimming pools, and we could go on a trip back to the old country.
Joe, why can't you be happy with what we've already got?
What have we got?
We've got each other.
Yeah, I know. And it's good. Hmm. But even talking about all those other things, you know, I mean, what is it, some kind of un-American to want something better?
No, Joe. It's not un-American. Come on, let me warm up your coffee. Well, that's strange.
What's strange?
This box. I'm sure that wasn't there before. Oh, it's beautiful. Joe, look, there's something in it.
Let me see. It's a map. It looks like this coastline. And this is the lagoon here. Yeah, it looks like a treasure map. Hey, look here in this circle. Doesn't this look like one of those ancient gods like Zeus? No, wait a minute. No, yeah, it looks like a Triton, isn't it?
Yeah, Mr. Rock did say we were going to be rich.
Yeah. Joe, where are you going?
Diving.
Diving?
Yeah, what have I got to lose?
You will be completely isolated. I hope this house is as you remember yours.
It is. It's exactly like the house we grew up in. That was my room up there. Tom and I used to play.
There is still time to cancel your fantasy, Miss Conti.
Claire, maybe we should. This whole thing, I just don't like it.
No, Eddie. If Tom's ever going to reach me, I think it'll be here.
Incredible. This place gives me the creeps. We played football right here.
Seems you're quite a magician, Mr. Rourke.
Magic, Mr. Lefevre? I'm just a man who fulfills fantasies. Nothing more. Enjoy your stay, Tatu.
Good day.
Certain your brother is in this house.
Claire, don't you realize what nonsense this is?
All I know is that Tom wants to speak to me.
And if he does, what will he say? He was a degenerate gambler, staggering under a morass of debts.
I realize that Tom was in trouble, Uncle Victor. But I also know that he wouldn't commit suicide.
Mr. Lefevre, with all due respect, I don't think this is the time to bicker.
Oh, really?
Ed is right. We've come this far. We should get on with it.
Madame Bork?
Tonight. Midnight. The seance will begin.
You're not used to these steps.
Yeah, I know. But I'll be all right. Well, I guess this looks like about it. I'm not going to see much from up here, so I guess I'll have to go down.
Oh, Joe, be careful.
I'll be fine.
Thank you. It's gold. It's pure gold.
Gold? Oh, my God. We really are rich.
Tom Conti, I know you are here. I feel you are here. Tom, your dear twin sister is with us. She wants to talk to you.
Well, the next on the program is floating crumpets and perhaps a phosphorus dip sheet.
Shh.
Tom? Tom, can you hear me? There's nobody here. Like seaweed.
I'm all right. You saw Tom. You all saw him. You heard him.
I heard him. He said, murdered me.
He was here.
This is all crazy. Now, Tom committed suicide. And besides that voice that we heard, nothing more than a mumble.
He wants to tell his sister more. There must be another seance. His spirit will not rest until he speaks again.
He did say he was murdered. Maybe what he wants to tell you is by whom.
Mm-hmm.
someone there.
Because the murderer knew that Tom's spirit would only speak to his sister. With Claire dead, he or she would be safe.
Boss, what was that? A bird? A plane? A man?
That tattoo was Mr. Stanley Cronin, a client whose fantasy was to be more than a mild-mannered newspaper reporter.
You don't mean...
I don't. See for yourself.
On Fantasy Island.
Good afternoon,
Mrs. Kapos.
Why aren't you inside celebrating your husband's good fortune along with his newfound friends?
Well, I just needed some fresh air.
And some quiet.
That's enough for the day.
Hey, don't forget, Joe, we're throwing another party for you tonight in the main room. We're going to have some real, real good fun.
Yeah, I'll be there.
Joe, buddy, some bozo wants to sell you some stock in his new corporation. Tell him to get lost. Listen, Joe, don't listen to those cheap paper hangers. Now, I've got something first rate for you, something that's exactly made for you.
Can I get you something, Joe?
No, nothing. Just enjoy.
Well, in that case...
Eva!
Perhaps we should come back at a more convenient time.
No, it's okay, Mr. Rock. What can I do for you? Just shut off the music!
Well, are you certain that your friends will not mind if I discuss business? I have news.
Fantastic news.
An hour ago, I phoned the mainland and conferred with some of the world's foremost experts in ancient Mediterranean art. I described your find, and their consensus was that this could be the missing statuette of the sea god Triton. If so, it could be worth millions.
Millions? Did you say millions?
I did indeed. And one of the authorities is en route to Fantasy Island at this very moment. He should arrive this evening.
Say, what if that thing's not real?
Whether it is Triton or not, so much gold and such exquisite work must be worth an emperor's ransom. Will you excuse us and enjoy yourselves? Tattoo?
funny, boss.
Well, I should think not. Watching another man grow rich while you two had the same old fantasies still unfulfilled.
You know that's not it. Sometimes I don't understand you, boss. Look at all the phonies around him. They're making him crazy. And poor Mrs. Capos all alone.
That bothers you, Tatu?
But of course it bothers me. Don't you remember how happy they were the first time they arrived here? What happened? And since you found that thing that...
You still think what happened last night was a trick?
Madame Warwick. Well, it's either that or believing in ghosts. And I'm not quite prepared to do that.
I found out why the telephone doesn't work. Someone cut the wires.
Cut the wires? Are you sure?
Oh, I'm sure. They cut them with these.
Then someone wants us isolated. But why?
To kill again. Whoever murdered your brother Tom will never be safe as long as you're alive and he can contact you.
Do you really believe that one of us is a murderer, don't you?
Those telephone wires didn't cut themselves. That and what happened last night, I'd say that's a pretty good guess. Claire? Is this really so important?
Yes. I must know the truth about Tom's death.
But if anything ever happened to you... I love you very much.
I love you too, Eddie. But I have to go through with this.
Boss, you got to help me.
What's wrong, Tatu?
You know the horse who kept following me?
You mean the one over there?
Yeah, that one. I'm in real trouble. This is a poster. A reward poster for $1,000 for the capture of a horse thief. Me.
Dead or alive?
Huh. Oh, boss, did you have to say that?
Tatu, why don't you merely return the horse to its owner?
I can't.
Well, why not?
Because I love him.
Well, perhaps you could buy him.
I can't. I'm too broke.
In that case, I have the perfect solution.
What is it?
Arrest yourself for stealing the animal, collect the reward money, and then use it to buy the horse. Simple.
Μαζεύεσαι δίκια, τώρα που σε πήρω εγώ γουρεύεις χουλαρίκια. Come on, Eva, get dressed. You're gonna make us late.
So what if we are a few minutes late, Joe?
What's the matter with you anyway?
Joe, you know, you always said that we'd have children whenever you struck it rich.
Later, Eva, we got people waiting.
Always later, Joe. Always for some reason.
You're turning into a nag and a killjoy.
Joe, please. This is very important to me.
I'm sick of this. I'm not going to keep our friends waiting. I'll see you down at the party. So, will you dress up for a change, huh? I remember. Now, you're a millionaire's wife now, huh? Not some scrub woman.
Look like a tub. You know those Greeks that got those big...
Excuse me a minute. Captain, you're trying to do, huh? You're trying to make a fool out of me in front of my friends. Can I tell you to get something decent on?
Joe, please, I've got to talk to you.
Get back and take these rags off and you put something decent on them. Go on! Crazy or something?
Boss, he's going back to the party. Does he not care about her anymore?
Congratulations, Mr. Kappas.
You mean it's...
absolutely authentic.
Tom Conti, are you with us? Claire wants you to speak to her. Unburden yourself of whatever dreadful thing it is that's troubling you.
Gonna cheat me out of it. Don't you understand? No one should have the money. I'm the one who should be rich.
Not Tom or Claire.
I'm the one who deserved it.
Then you did kill Tom.
Yes. I did.
Claude, why?
Because he lost all that money to me and then he wouldn't pay me back.
He wouldn't pay. So I drugged him. I took him up to the bridge. Pushed him over. And it was easy.
It's like dumping a sack of potatoes. Yes, I killed him. Just like I'm gonna kill you! Claude!
Claude, give me the knife.
It's real. Eva!
Dearest Joe, I would not stand in the way of your happiness, but there's no place for me here, nor for the children I wanted. So it's best that I go. Even away from you, I shall always love you. Your Eva.
What are you talking about?
She's gone.
What did you expect, Mr. Kappas?
What have I done, Mr. Rock? She was the thing that meant the most to me, the thing that I love the most, and now... I've driven her away.
Oh, but Mr. Kappas, you are a very wealthy man.
Wealthy. Wealthy. I never felt so poor in all my life.
Well, then perhaps you should do something to change your circumstances, Mr. Kappas.
Nothing.
Eva! Eva!
You, it's really you, Eva.
Yes, Joe, yes. I'm deeply indebted to you for everything.
You are indeed welcome, Miss Conti.
Just for the record, Mr. Rourke.
Yes, madam.
I didn't use any devices or tricks to create the image of Tom Conti. It was quite real.
Yes. So I'm told.
Goodbye.
Goodbye, madam.
Goodbye.
Goodbye, Miss Conti.
Goodbye. Thank you.
Mr. Loomis, you're welcome.
Goodbye.
Goodbye.
Boss.
Yes?
If Madame Vorik didn't create the ghost of Tom Conti, who did?
Don't look at me.
Boss, you done it. I'm sure you did it.
Tattoo, did anyone have to create it? Isn't it just possible that what those people heard and saw was, in fact, the ghost of Tom Conti?
You mean the ghost was a real ghost?
Goodbye, Mr. Rourke. We owe you thanks for so much. And thank you, Tattoo.
You're welcome.
Goodbye, Mrs. Kappos, and may you always be as happy as you look today. You as well, Mr. Kappos.
Well, I don't really know how to thank you.
Sometimes a man's happiness is so deep inside him that he may forget it's there and start looking elsewhere, hunting a fantasy, an illusion. It happens to all of us now and then.
By the way, Mr. Kappos, how did it feel to be rich?
I don't think I could go through that again. Not for $1 million.
You're very well. Goodbye.
Goodbye.
Goodbye, Mr. Kappos.
Come on, baby.
Thank you, gentlemen. I never enjoyed myself more.
Our pleasure, Miss McLeod.
One parting question.
Yes?
What would Joe Kappos have done had he known that the Triton statuette was worth about $20 retail?
Well, he probably would have done the same thing had he known that you are really a fry cook in New Jersey, Mr. McLeod.
What are you doing here? I told you to stay away from me. You know what happened to me if your owner see me? Huh? And if he sees us together? Oh my God, boss. Here he comes. You know what I do to a horse thief?
No, what?
Here's the bill of sale for your horse, Mr. Rourke. Oh, and I threw the saddle and bridle in for good measure.
Oh, thank you, Mr. Ferrin.
Boss, did you really buy that horse for me?
More precisely, I've loaned you the money, Tattoo. But it will be deducted from your salary. A small amount every month for the next 2 years. Is that all right?
Boss, thank you. Thank you so much.